want to say anything to Geneva?
Geneva?
Yeah.
Well, hello, sister. I wish you were here to play in the playroom here with us today. I hope this video will be to your liking and that you will enjoy it for many years to come. Of course, perhaps you can come back another Christmas. We miss you. We love you. Bye-bye.
You got the drummer boy in Kentucky? The little Santa on the piano he's had for years. And of course, Mother's great love, Mickey and Minnie. Little toy that the great grandchildren go nuts over. You want to start the music box? want to say anything about the little village up here on the piano or on the mantle?
Just that it's here.
Did you have the phone?
No, I didn't.
Yeah.
With all this going, I got the ticket ready. My daughter and I are going to the Hale Theater. And Carl's going downtown to the,
Home Show thing.
Yeah, he's going down there. Yeah. Carrie's just finishing up video on something. It's amazing that everything's going. She was making a video.
I remember the little trip when I'm 48 years old.
Well, Carrie's going with me. We go to the theater together. We've got season tickets. Yeah, she's not here for any other purpose than that. But I'll say hello to her. Do you have another time this week that you could... Yeah. Well, if you don't stay on time, you're down there at the hill, we don't miss you. So we have to go on time. Whatever. Well, it's still going to be up for a while, so, find somebody else. Okay? I'm too sorry. Okay.
There's a miniature Disneyland underneath the tree. Popeye. This little gingerbread house Calvin made, better than mine, Minecraft.
Inspired by the Festival of Trees.
We went to the Festival of Trees, and when his mother asked him what he wanted to do, he said, oh. And he did. And he ate half the M&Ms, too.
While he was down there.
Thank you. Oh, good. I didn't get the train on my video.
Huh?
Yep.
What get this done, we'll try and get those spots out of your dress.
It's gonna be better than my video that I did for the grandchildren. I got her on tape. I noticed her. Where's that little kitty?
I can't find him.
And Goofy and Pluto, I saw.
Oh, I got hillbilly pencil on here with my hillbilly, see? Carl showed this to some other things. See, this is Ann's pencil. She used to write with it. She's a kid that can.
Remember getting this little dog?
Yeah. This is a craftsman tool that is going to be hung next year. I can't see it. I added these this year. I think they're cute. See Pitchfork?
Mm-hmm.
This is Sun. And it says, no one can fill your boots. You see, he's laying in a hammock.
Mm-hmm.
His boots.
That's one of the first ones you had, was Pluto.
Yeah. Yeah. I added this this year. Isn't that cute?
Mm-hmm. There's the little toy soldier I made you, one of the first years.
Yeah.
Where's your...
Yeah, that she gave me this summer.
Oh, yeah, in the little basket?
Yeah. University of Kentucky stuff.
Oh, there's Adam and Eve.
Thank you. Isn't that funny? I only put it up yesterday. One would think I could remember what. I guess Carl didn't hear us come in.
This is the Main Street USA in Disneyland.
And I put a Campbell soup kit on a spoon. If you're careful. Do you want me to turn that on?
Mm-hmm. Show me Wonder Woman first.
Right there.
Wonder Woman for Dot.
Let me put these. I think I'll just remove these. They're over more than they're up. And this really interferes.
You want to say anything to anybody else in Kentucky since already talked to Geneva? Do you want to talk to your nephew or your cousin? Or she'll probably show this video to everybody.
See what you could see in person, Robert, if you come out. Besides seeing your pretty face. It would be heavenly. I really don't know where I hung the daughter one. Did you find Adam and Eve?
Yeah.
Gotta
lift
a candle.
I got it.
And boy, that is missing from there.
Wanna go down and film your dogs?
not never having no schooling, knowing no better. But now I'm all straightened out. I've been saved by the law.
Maybe the Comanche contact man won't know him in my sight.
You want me to take his place, take those guns to Sweetwater and meet the contact man?
Hey, that ain't a bad idea. And you're sure welcome to use my name. That thing. Epic thing. Maybe that'll wake up some. The way I almost disgraced it. Think of me being mixed up with them. Me who ain't never been in no trouble before. Well, not hardly.
All right, Big Dean.
Just a minute. I might want to do a little reading tonight. Either one of you gentlemen got an extra Bible?
What time is it, Grandpa?
It's almost 5 o'clock. We better get a move on.
Hey, that new hair made looks good. But why can I see it?
Because it's a miracle in the flesh.
That's really neat. It's like almost invisible. You know, for a long time, me and Grandpa never talked.
I couldn't make out what she was saying, including ways to help myself. You know, it's sad going through life not hearing what your family's saying, particularly when you might learn how to help yourself with this free 15-minute video.
Tell me some more about fishing, Grandpa.
If you're missing what friends and family are telling you, call the toll-free number now for your free 15-minute video, Hearing Loss and You. No cost or obligation, so call right now.
Hey, Mr. B, underneath this friend's head. Oh, sorry about the truck.
We should go to Midas.
That's a very good idea.
They'll fix it right now.
Well, kind of busy. Of course, things change.
At Midas, we'll find your exhaust problem. Explain your options so you'll know what to do. It's the Midas way, a better system for you and your car.
I love this place, Ned.
It's Ted.
Whatever.
Midas, auto systems experts.
Believe what's possible these days? Travel arrangements, right from your own computer, instant stock quotes, and can you believe unlimited use of the world's number one internet online service for one low monthly fee? America Online. Join today.
There I am in Ireland. You get the red box, the blue box, what? That's when I remembered Tavis B. It's got the only antihistamine with 12 hours of clinically proven relief.
I am proving it right now.
This is TBS TechWatch, brought to you by Ralston Purina Company of Checkerboard Square.
This is Steve Mann, although there's a lot of machine to him as well. An MIT student, he's wired his entire life for the internet. His gear includes a portable computer and a visor with a computer screen and a tiny camera, all hooked up to the net. He's serious about developing a practical use for his device, helping the visually impaired see better. You can check out his progress at wearcam.org. For TBS TechWatch, I'm Dick Wilson.
As long as this thing's been going, we've been chasing it. It's an obsession with it.
Chuck, we've gone days without seeing anything.
And there it is right there. You can see its ears and its drum.
Come on, buddy. Come on, baby.
Steve, look at this. Look at that 10 o'clock.
Hey, stop that!
It's a woodchuck.
Nothing, right?
It's a woodchuck. Forget it. Sorry.
It just keeps going and going, and therefore you yourself have to keep going.
This has been TBS TechWatch. Now, back to Big Shots and the Comancheros on the Superstation.
Even the laundry room has knickknacks and dolls all over.
Oh, yes, sir.
grateful to meet you, buddy.
Just a minute. Hello, little Christopher. Hello, pretty baby bird. Hello, pretty baby bird. Gonna say anything, huh? Christopher Graber, Christopher Graber. Gonna say anything, huh? Merry Christmas, Happy New Year. I know, I'm just getting some of them through the window. And huh? I'm just getting some of them through the window.
Oh, through there?
Mm-hmm, from your door. I got your bird.
What, did you act nice and talk? Did you act nice and talk, huh? Yeah, what's up, Doc? What's up, Doc? You wanna call Lady? Lady, you wanna call Lady? You wanna call Lady? Christopher Graver, pretty baby boy, bird, pretty bird, baby, Christopher baby. Graver baby, pretty bird baby.
Hi, Lady. Oh, he's not gonna pose for me now.
Lady. Lady. This doesn't look very good up there either. I want to see you better. Pretty baby. Pretty baby.
California. Too bad I didn't get everybody this morning. We had homemade bread and jam. Hi, Pop. He's, they call him Polly Homemaker, right?
Molly Homemaker.
Molly Homemaker. Lincoln, California.
This is the first one we have to feed.
We're on our morning trek to feed the wild animals here.
The wild animals, yeah. These are spaghetti squash. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna give some of those to Mary.
Okay.
Jesse bought this from a friend. It doesn't work, so. Okay. You better watch your feet now. It's just kind of rough territory.
You hear the birds chirping?
You almost drink a bathtub of water a day.
He hears his two cows and they're both pregnant. Okay.
Eventually I'll come up with a name.
Mm-hmm. Oh, the other one's coming over to see you. What's in there?
My worm farm.
Oh, no. Worms too, huh?
Yeah. We grow them and then put them in the garden and plant the garden.
And chickens? We had good eggs this morning.
The smell that you smell?
Uh-huh.
My next door neighbor has 200 pigs. Right here. Whoops. Oh, that almost got you.
I love the chirping birds.
Boy, it's getting warm already.
kind of wire stacks that Paul grows his tomatoes and his cucumbers on. He makes use of every little space everywhere he goes. Look at me, Paul. Morning. He starts his day about 5 o'clock in the morning.
These are the bees.
Oh.
Uh-oh.
What? Beehives.
I got a hive that's dying here.
How many pounds of honey did you say you got? 70 last year?
70 pounds.
70 pounds of honey, and he eats bee pollen every day?
See, I've got a problem here. I don't know what's happening with this hive. This hive's never been as active as it is right now. And I've never seen as much wax out here in the front. So I don't know what's going on. Oh, look down here. What in the heck is going on? I think my hive died.
Oh, really?
Yes, it did. There's the worms.
Worms may cause it to die?
Yes. Doggone it.
Ants can't get it.
Keep it filled with hot pepper juice. Until they... Oh, man, this thing stinks.
I guess the worms have got into his hive and have killed the hive off here. He has buckets of cans of water for the lakes to keep the ants from infiltrating.
I don't know if there's anything I can do about that hive. That hive's about 2 years old. I hate to lose a hive.
Where are we going now?
To the shed.
What's in the shed?
Hay. I don't have any grass. I mowed it all down. Then when the rains come, then the grass comes up quicker and there's more feed for the cattle.
Oh. The cows like Paul. Horses. My little neighbor has 200 pigs. Dog. Hello, doggy.
Expanding this a bit. I want to make a better area down there where I feed them so that I can lock them in, give them shots if I need to give them shots or whatever else. Mm-hmm. Then we're going to expand this a little bit further, and then we're going to build another loft like this over there, and that's where I'm going to put my new chicken coop.
Oh. Keep them close together then.
Huh? Well, it's just all in one place. I've got water back here now. I just got that in here about 3 or 4 months ago. That's something I've wanted to do for 16 years.
Yeah.
Come see our pig next door.
You like your life, right?
Oh, yeah. Very contented.
Huh? I'll zero in on the pigs.
You're going to have to Watch where you put your feet, too, because this ground's pretty...
covered, huh?
Well, there's a lot of water down in here, and so the cattle mash the dirt down.
You saying good morning, huh? Hi, neighbors. I'm Paul's sister from Salt Lake.
Oh, hi there.
Hi.
This is the mill race.
Welcome to the pig.
You named them all, huh?
Oh, yeah, they're all named. Let's see, who is this? This is Darla. You're next, Daisy.
You're in here looking for eggs.
Got 8 of them today.
Wow.
That's about what we ate this morning.
Oh, I see your pumpkins.
Yeah.
They're pretty. What's in the square boxes?
Nothing right now. I got a few things. Here, you want to take those ones?
Eggs. What have you got out here?
This is just pumpkins right here.
Woo-wee, look at that!
The one I thought I'd give Mary.
Oh, great. They'll have a ball with that one.
That one probably weighs about 35-40 pounds.
My brother, the farmer, and insurance man, and father, and scout leader.
This pumpkin here, like this, we can cut it down and into 2-pound sections, and we get about 78 cents a pound for it.
Ooh.
A lot of money. That means this pumpkin's almost worth $40. You ever eat an eggplant?
Nope.
That's a good plant this year. Right there.
Oh, I've seen them at the store though.
See?
Yeah.
It's just loaded with eggplant.
What does it taste like?
These are my strawberries. I just kind of let the garden go, and I just keep the things alive that need to be kept alive.
Hey, you used the little pot, the little labels that I gave you.
Oh, yeah. Then this is my broccoli that I planted for my winter garden. I was hoping I planted it early enough so I could get a crop before Christmas, and I am. There's a crop that's coming up here right now. And the rest I'll probably eat next spring sometime. These are just flowers that are volunteer flowers in here, so I let them grow and come up, and they'll reseed themselves.
Hmm.
And I've got onions over here. And then Cheryl planted zinnias, and now she's just letting them go so she can collect the seeds.
And plant more next year.
Yeah, so we can plant more next year.
Sure, we're going back home now.
Bad.
Uh-huh.
Because the top layer is just fine. And I'll put a new base on it and a new top on it, bring it in over here in the wheelbarrow, go over here to the tree, and try and shake all those bees back into the hive, hopefully with the queen. And if I'm successful in doing that, then taking the hive back over there, they will they'll restart their hive in that one box.
And so he saved it.
Yeah. Huh?
So you're saving it.
So I'm able to save it, yeah.
Oh, that's a happy day for you.
It's quite expensive to start hives. It runs about $60 for each colony that you want to purchase. Unless you start your own colony, but I'm not that sophisticated yet. I don't know how to do that yet. The bees are out. I'm coming up my pants.
Is that outfit that you put on specially thick or something so they can't penetrate it?
No, they can penetrate it sometimes. I get stung. But one of the nice things about working with the bees is you learn not to be afraid. You learn not to be.
What does the rubber gloves do?
So they don't sting my hand.
Hmm.
That stops them from going up my sleeve. They're going to be mad at me.
Why? Because you're taking their hive down?
Well, just anytime you fool around with them, they think you're messing with them, and so they get kind of mad at you. That swarm will be a little ticklish to get into the hive.
You're all ready now, huh?
Not quite.
What do you want this?
I need to take a
What are you doing?
Pits.
What are you doing there now?
I'm tying the hood down so that the bees can't get up underneath the hood. Because if there's an opening, they'll find it. As long as they can't find an opening, they can't sting me. But if they find an opening, I will definitely get stung. One time when I did this, I got stung 8 times.
Oh my gosh.
It didn't feel good.
Or not?
Yeah.
Okay.
The Winnie the Pooh song?
Oh, yeah. Oh, going for the honey.
Doesn't that look nasty?
Yeah. Ooh-wee. Tons of bees around there.
The problem is, if I didn't get the queen in there, they won't go in. So I don't know if I got the queen in there.
Gotta say hi, at least, just hi. That's the mother of this beautiful child. And that's her mother. And this is Julie. Hi, Julie. Hi there.
Can she walk?
Oh, look at that. She's standing up good.
Oh. From the couch to there, everywhere.
My granddaughter can't do that yet. Julia! Turn around here so I can see her pretty little face. Oh, there she goes. Hi, precious. Man, she sure got a lot of hair. How many teeth does she have?
None.
None? Oh, my goodness.
I like that spoon.
She's going to eat your hair, Amy.
It talks to her.
Really?
Is it talking to her?
Oh.
Yummy, yummy.
Better walk over to your mom, Amy. I'll get that on tape.
Hi.
says, I'm not going to look at you. I know you're taking my picture. Yes, you are.
My beauty. My beauty.
There's a good smile. Get her to smile again, Amy.
She's just fascinated with Amy because she's there.
There, now we got a smile.
Let her walk to me.
Well, she's going to her mama. She knows there's some presents there, huh? There she goes. There's a smile. There's a smile.
All of the info pictures that I have look just like Julia.
Julia, who are you smiling at? You could write grandma? Yeah?
God can be good about those kind of things when you've got a single mom raising a baby. Right? God just works it out that way so there's never any questions. It just looks like home. I'm amazed.
Over there.
The second one down. Second one over.
Yeah, a little bit of trouble there.
Here you go. From the left. Oh, that's her too, yeah.
Come on.
This is her.
Come on.
Come on. Come on.
I think Amy kind of likes her, huh? Where are you going? Over to grandma again.
Uh-oh.
Where? Oh, that's a nice four-generation picture. Oh, her too.
Amy, don't get rambunctious, Kate.
Where's
She's just a little baby.
Mary.
She wants you.
That's it's so far. I'm not sure what we're up to.
I don't think I can get those pictures on the wall. I think they're too far. Is that what just happened? This is the view from Mary's house of the lake. These are blackberries and raspberries on their way down to Glass Beach, and we're at Fort Bragg.
Oh, I found some.
Oh, right on.
Look at that.
A whole pile of
blackberries. Messy.
Good old blackberries.
Mm-hmm. Right off the vine.
Out right there.
See bars?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, these bushes, Mom. You can see when people make paths.
Right up there. There's a whole huge, long coast. Oh, you said stay to the left.
What'd you say?
We need to keep taking every right we have. Yeah, otherwise...
down to the ocean. Lots of foliage around here. Now tell us about this beach, Mary. Tell us about this beach.
Where an accumulation of glass has washed up over the years, and the ocean has made it smooth, fine, and the pieces are just completely rounded and
gorgeous.
Glass for the glass beach.
This is all glass.
It is?
Yeah. Okay. Look how soft and rounded those corners are.
Ooh, I'm going to get a whole bunch of that.
Isn't that beautiful?
I told the kids I was going to bring him something home. I'll bring him home.
Glass.
A glass. Sarah, run to me.
She found baby crab crabs.
I mean, like real crabs.
Were they baby crabs or mommy crabs? I want crabs.
No, it's all the one of my teeth.
And it's
honey,
up and down rocks.
When Mike and I found the crab, it was in the sand. We dug it up in the sand.
I'll put my shorts on.
Little picture in there.
How far
is it? He's right over that thing. That's where I jumped up. Set my phone. Oh, I love it. You've got to go over there. It is so loud. Seaweed. Sarah's showing us some seaweed now.
Oh, show wow. Me. Barnacles.
Huh?
Barnacles.
Barnacles, and that's what the sailors used to chip off the end of their
ship.
Yeah,
and whales have them, and some whales will go up like and scrape their backs on the bottom of the boat. I'm not filming you because I have to change here.
I'm not. I'm filming the beach, the seaweed and everything.
Oh,
it
Mama,
feels
that's a
so
sea urchin
good.
Too.
It's so good. They found some crabs.
Found a starfish!
Oh!
It's a starfish!
Let's see that starfish.
Still alive, too.
Where is it? Oh, it's a little... Wait a minute, I'm too close. I'm too close. Where, hold her up, Sarah.
Oh,
there it is, a little starfish.
I gotta go put it back now.
Okay. Okay, show me from there what that is.
This is how the shells grow. See? There's a coral there too.
That's coral, huh?
Right there, there's some coral right there.
Oh, I'll be done.
She's a shell that grows inside these little thingies here.
Cool. And Sarah wants to be a marine biologist. My feet in the sand. Not sand, but glass all along the beach that Mary has collected, as far as you can see, but the ocean has washed up. says pause when there. Can you see it?
It says record.
Okay, now it's on record.
Okay, this is me at Fort Bragg in the ocean. This is about as far as I'm going to get. I really don't like water, but I love to look at it. And all along the beach, I've been gathering rocks or pieces of glass, seashells. Barry and Sarah brought me down. Today is October 10th, 1969. Rebecca?
1996, Carrie.
What did I say, 69?
Yeah.
Look back.
How do I zoom this puppy?
Top button. Yeah. Zoom out there, zoom away, whatever. I guess I'll stand up and just drag me in.
She's in the water.
You gotta get the live crabs on tape, bro.
Ooh, I like the summer crabs. Bring up some more. Okay, I'm gonna go on the other side. Come on, Ron.
The ocean washes up the
all
bottles.
Glass.
Not sand, but glass. We're going to scoop up sacks full of it. You can use it for making jewelry or in the aquarium or just as a nice souvenir. All of this. Stop, I can't get you to get too closer.
He looks like he's dead.
He's not dead. He's clacking. He's clacking his jaws.
Hold him up so I can see him. Oh, that's Sarah's crab.
It's my.
fish on here.
Oh, okay. Well, I didn't know whether you wanted me to leave your clothes or not. But some people do, I guess.
You ever touched a starfish?
Yeah. Boathouse, the bar and Mexican food restaurant. Pretty nice place.
Do not wash. This vehicle is undergoing a scientific dirt test.
How you doing?
What lake is this called?
Clear Lake. Now we're from Mount Katahdin. If you can see it through the trees.
I hear some ducks.
Oh, they go crazy. We feed them every day. That's where one of my bosses lives, right here on the ground. Are you still filming?
Mm-hmm. Oh. But I got the mountain off.
That's Mount Kanata.
Why is it important?
Yeah, it's historical.
Why?
That's the volcano. Huh? I'll wait till you stop filming to tell you.
Palm trees. This is what she gets to work with every day, this beautiful lake, serving people out here on the patio or the dock. Another palm tree. Pacific. There's Mary.
Say hi to the camera, Bill.
Hey, hi. Hi, Bill. I'm Mary's sister from the Spotlight. This is where Mary works. It's called the Boathouse. She makes it some food, restaurant. What?
That's Latino.
Oh. Everything in here. They have a pool table. Okay.
Yeah.
Is that your customer?
Bob Martinez?
What?
What's your name again?
He's from there. That's a dirty word. Am I lying?
Do you want to be on my video?
You know what?
This is my sister Carrie Ann.
How do you do?
And she's also the soon to be.
Oh.
And you're on film now.
This is the famous cook. Really good thing. So you're the one that fixes all that good Mexican food, right?
Oh, yeah.
I heard about it.
I went someplace else.
Joyce.
Hi, Joyce. She's hopping around in there.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Well, let's get him.
Bob out there on the lake. We're watching him come in if it is. That's Bob's boat. It's up on the hill. The restaurant gives them all their chips and stuff every day, so they're pretty fat ducks. I got that.
Bob, say hi.
Hi, how are you? What we ought to do is play the guitar and she can take a picture of us doing Stewball.
Stewball. I'll sing it, I'll sing it.
You will?
Yeah.
Cool. Well, where's Sarah? Oh, that's right, she's out jamming with the band.
No, she's here.
Oh.
She said it was too late to go. And they decided they wanted to get to know each other better, so.
Cool. Well, all right, well, why don't you take pictures when we play music?
Okay.
When we'll be doing something.
Bob, go
see, that's the trouble.
What's your full name, Bob?
My name is Robert Wesley.
Robert Wesley? I have a Robert, too.
I had trouble with your mom. Here.
He's drank wine. And his bridle was silver. But his bridle was silver. And his name, it was gold. And the worth of his saddle has never been told. Fairgrounds were crowded.
Have her stand over there.
And old Stewball was there. And the bedding was heavy. Halfway round, when the gray mare she stumbled and she fell to the ground, and away up yonder, Lord, away up yonder, ahead of them all, Lord, ahead of them all came a prancing and dancing. Jack of diamonds, but you've taken my soul, and you've robbed from my pockets all my silver and gold. And the hoot owl, she hollered, Lord, the hoot owl, she hollered, and the turtle da moon, and the turtle da moon. I'm a poor boy in trouble, and a long way from home. But the Screwball was a race.
You guys are teasing me.
He never drank water. Cool. Now what?
That's one of Carrie Ann's favorite songs.
Really?
Yes.
For all of her life, she's been
called. You're an old Peter Paul and Mary fan?
Mm-hmm. But I only knew the chorus. I didn't know the words. So now I got them on tape.
What?
I didn't know you brought your harmonica.
Sure.
We can just rock on tonight.
Yes, he's a man of multi-talents. Do you want to shred some?
What song are you going to sing now?
Oh, this is a song called Out of the Blue, and it was written by...
I like that song.
It was written by a friend of mine and I, and it's one of the feature songs on my first album.
Oh.
I can
listen
to
two
verses down.
Unchained the Melody. Okay, I didn't know which one it was called.
Oh, my love, my darling, I hunger for your touch along the line. And time goes by so slowly, and time can do so much. Are you still mine? I need your love. I need
to be. Lonely rivers flow to the sea, to the sea. Open arms of the sea. Lonely rivers cry, wait for me, wait for me. Oh, I'll be coming home, wait for me. Oh, my love, my darling, I hunger for your touch. Time goes by so slowly, and time can do so much. Are you still mine? I need your love. I need your love. Godspeed, love to.
That's it. Unchained Melody, huh? This is the view from Mary's deck. DJ, don't let it!
DJ's on it. Yep. Well, sometimes they do that just to bring it back around. Where? Who's got shin guards?
You see her toe running?
Good. You found him?
Good girl!
Yay. All right! Defense!
Get the ball, Sam!
Good girl, Sam! Take it! Get in!
Yeah.
Good save. That was good. That was a really good one. Oh,
the car, yeah. She jumped from the audio director. She's so funny. I could put my hair in. Good. 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 Good.
Good.
What's the crumper?
It's sponsored by a winery.
It's sponsored by a winery.
What's the line on the goal kit?
Good girl, Katie! Good save!
Get the ball, Sam!
Don't wait for the ball!
Take it, Raquel! Head her off and take it! Head her off, Raquel!
Go!
Krista,
save it! Kick it!
That's okay. She did good.
Go, girl!
Hey, Michaela, you found it. We were looking for you.
All right, I need you.
Yeah,
all right.
Get
in there, Raquel. Take your ball.
Yeah,
no.
So tiny. She is. She's just so little. It's yours, Katie. There you go. Stay on it. Stay on it.
Hey, what's that?
Megan Joy.
Come on, keep it.
I just kind of got it close there.
Get on it, Sam. There you go. There you go.
Get it again.
Katie! Come on, you're throwing, Katie.
Get up there. Up there.
Up, okay.
Feet on the ground, Katie. Both feet on the ground.
Get ready, get ready.
Throw it.
Go, go, pick it up.
Get on the ball.
She's never thrown it right in front of the goal.
Right there, right there, right there.
There's nobody there by Samantha, and she's
throwing
it
to
me.
Sam, get on the ball.
Go get it, Raquel. Take it away.
Get the ball.
There you go.
In doubt, pick it up.
Down the side. I can't. No, you can. You're mom.
Oh, really?
Nope, can't close from behind.
Hey, Brittany! How you doing?
Hey, Brittany!
Mom's getting all freaked out. What are we gonna do? I don't know. That was good, Jesus.
Yeah! Get it away from the goal!
Get it out of there!
Hey, Brittany!
There you go, there you go.
She just dove right down there, though. She's not afraid. Megan Joy kicked that one. Good girl.
Get on the ball.
Take it away, Katie!
Katie's trying to play
her position. Yes, she is. I know, she's fighting going forward.
Stay silly, girl. Stay silly.
Yeah.
What's the goal is when you go down for the ball, okay?
Tripping their own players.
Megan, I'm going to put you in the goalie guard next quarter, okay? If they say anything, we're going to have to pull you off.
Put her ball on some cheekers. So now we have extra players sitting down.
Mm-hmm. Sure, they don't have a banner, so we're going to cheer come out there to the casino, okay?
Get the ball, Sam!
Get it out of there! Yeah, Amy, throw that ball!
Do it again!
Save it, Katie!
Go! Defense, Sam!
chasing it. Yeah!
Hey, Raquel, stop, stop, stop!
They got them all, kiddo.
Gotta line up. Line up, positions. They kick the ball from
one side to the other. Michaela! They gotta go!
They gotta
go! Gotta wait till the corner!
Oh no! Good one! Yeah, good move! Good move!
Kick it in!
At least. Hell, the last two quarters.
Usually they are.
You haven't been on this end of the field.
No, usually they're all on this end of the field.
Oh, yeah. You got to play aggressive.
Get over there, Sam.
See, and
Sam,
you got...
get up on that ball.
That's it. Take it. Kick it.
Michaela's out there diving. Yeah,
where they go?
Why
are you there,
Take it, yeah. You can't take an equipment timeout. Equipment timeout. That's it, drive!
My goodness.
Wanna see Whitney? This is her.
This is Beauty, one of our cats.
Mom, this is my cat. This is my cat. This is
Beauty.
This is Sadie.
And this is Whitney. Come here. This is Whitney. That is him.
Hmm. You're rolling all over these rocks.
Mm-hmm.
Here.
That's
come
cool.
Here. This is Sadie. This is Whitney.
And it's in the Mendocino National Forest.
Mendocino. Leave that alone.
It's a beautiful area. Mary said she wanted to go with her dogs where they would be free, where she could come and visit them forever and never have to worry about someone digging up their grave.
You can tell this one's still fresh. Mm-hmm. Oh, babies. Look at the shapes in these rocks. If that isn't a heart-shaped rock.
Yeah. What does it say? It
says, Whitney, we love and miss you. This one? Same thing, heart shape.
Cool.
Sadie Gurley, we love you. another heart-shaped rock. Look at that.
That's perfect.
Looks like a headstone.
November 95, August 96. We love you.
And I put the... That was Chris's goodbye. See you, Twitney.
Oh,
that one?
Yeah, 15
feet,
pound
4
right there.
Okay.
Hello there.
Hi there. Boy, don't look at this house, come on.
So you're Papa, you're the famous Papa.
Yeah.
I'm getting you on video.
Yeah, okay. You gotta come in so the cats don't come in, Carrie.
Huh? Right.
16 years.
Oh, that's pretty good.
Yeah.
You want to say anything to my mother?
I'll forget her name.
Ann.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Ann, yeah, I forgot your name, Annie. I just got home. I've been running, and go get me a taco here, or whatever you call them, burrito. I got, the thing went off. When I turn it back.
Okay.
Annie. All them kind of nuts. That's my little girl. That's a good. Now I got my day made. I take my hat off.
Okay.
Why, this house, I gotta get it straightened up here. Look at it. What's this thing here?
A coffee pot.
What's that?
Oh, it's where you pour your
creamer
thing into here. Yeah.
$10 for it. Guy sold it to me the other day.
They're old.
And so it's all brass, too. No, it's not brass plate. It's all made in Italy.
Oh, my. Happy Halloween, girls.
Yeah.
Show me your witch's hats. Your ice cream cones upside down on cookies filled with marshmallows and special messages for a bewitching Halloween.
Happy Halloween.
Yep. Grandmother?
Yeah.
Tell her hello for me.
Hey, Chris says hi. Can you take the camera away from me?
Okay, move your hand down and I will.
No, not until you take the camera away.
Sure you did.
Yeah, I'm not using it.
Philip, take me high. This is Teresa. I've had her since I was a baby. And before I was a baby.
Paul and Sarah's home and Paul is making eggplant casserole. We're all getting ready for church. I'm going to go up and surprise them all with the camera. These are some bookcases that Paul made to go around the steps so every bit of space was utilized in his home.
Don't get too dirty, all right? Don't get
frantic. Good morning, everyone.
Hi.
This is the crew getting ready for Sunday school. Any advice for me to take home?
No.
How about you, Tiff, before you leave on your mission?
You should always have more than two mirrors.
Oh.
Yeah.
Does that mean we need to send one with you on your mission?
I never thought about that.
I'm gonna take a camping one so it doesn't get broken. You know, one of those aluminum ones.
Yeah. I have a little plastic one that when it gets in there, it like sticks up, you know? It's plastic, it's got in there, and it's like a bit, it might get bigger or smaller, you know?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. You can take that.
I can send you one.
You can't send anything. You might not get it.
Are you serious?
Yeah. There's still a lot of stuff over
there.
Well,
you can't send anything?
We can send some stuff, but they get to go to it. What's this music I hear? It's great.
Johnny.
Who?
Johnny.
Johnny.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. Hey, Jess, I hear you're going to be an Eagle next year.
Yeah.
What?
Here's Mom. Hey, Mom. Any advice for the parting stranger here?
No, just take care.
Okay.
Fly safely.
Thank you. You always have good words of wisdom.
Watch it.
I take that back. I might want to take it. Okay.
Because I'll be out for you now.